Fuller's Power, back here on Championship Wrestling. Looking more powerful than ever, and we're set for the action to commence. Pole not doing too well, Bruno, with North, South, or Mark, or whatever.
He's not going to do anything with Putski. Putski's very, very powerful guy. He's got more experience. He's got better stamina. You name it, and he's got it over Pole.
I've just been notified that we will have an interview with the new tag team champions, Tony Garea and Larry Zbyszko. We'll also go back in time, and we'll show you exactly the way that match ended with Garea and Zbyszko on the victory. So we'll have them immediately following this match, time permitting. Well, now Pole raking the face of Putski and working on the eyes, I suppose. Bruno, I guess he's a desperate man. I guess he has to do something.
That's correct. That's the only way he's going to get Putski hurt anyway, by raking his eyes, what have you.
Whoa. Putski laying him in there. And Pole out on the concrete floor. Actually, I think he dove to the outside to get away, Bruno.
He was getting hit, and he was trying to run at the same time. And between the two, he took a pretty good blow out of that ring.
Back in now. Mark Pole whips the rope. There's a patented Polish hammer for the cover. One, looking at two, and look out at three. Just as powerful, if not more powerful than ever. Now let's get the official time.
It is a time, 2 minutes and 9 seconds, and the winner, the Polish Power, Ivan Putski.
The Polish Power of Ivan Putski, victorious. But ladies and gentlemen, Ivan Putski was not the only one who was victorious, because here, to my right, Larry Zbyszko and Tony Garea brought this crowd alive like they've never been alive before. Finally, defeating the Yukon Lumberjacks. And I know you guys are two of the happiest guys in the world.
That's certainly great, Vince. You know, we went time and time again. It was almost 2 years, Larry and I, being together. And, whether it be luck wasn't on our side or the manager's interfering. But as you noticed, I kept a good eye on Albano through that whole match. He came close to the ring. I came down my side of the ring and just let him know that I was watching him.
Through the thick and the thin of it, you guys stuck together. Larry, you had several opportunities in the past to defeat the Lumberjacks, but because they were keenly aware of this disqualification factor and things of that nature, you would defeat them, but not for the belt.
Well, you know, Vince, this bothered Tony and I for a long time. And we finally had to come up with a contract that specificated a one-fall match. Two out of three-fall matches were not safe with these people because they would take advantage of it and get themselves disqualified.
Again, let me ask you another question. Whether it was lady luck or whether you designed it this way, last week we saw you guys come down here and blatantly interfere in a match, although there was some justification because S.D. Jones was unquestionably hurt. But did you intend to trick Lou Albano into a situation where he'd be so hot he would issue the challenge? Is that back in your mind? Did you intend to do that, or did it just happen?
No, Vince, we didn't intend to do it. As far as Tony and I were concerned, we saw a friend of ours getting hurt. We saw one friend of ours that was hurt and one friend that was getting hurt. And we can't sit by and watch someone get hurt. Now, whether Lou Albano got mad and thought he was going to hurt us, well, he found out different. And, man, I am the happiest man in the world, Vince. I can't tell you.
All right, let's take a look at it, and you fellas can enjoy this now. Let's go back in time and take a look. Here it is, and Larry, you call it. What's happening here?
Okay, Tony and I hooked each other and spun each other around. It's a defensive move we practiced for years together, 2-3 years on this move, just in case it ever came about. It did. We capitalized on it.
From there, Tony's really giving it to Pierre, rather, but Eric
Kemper goes, forget it.
Hey, but here, look at this.
Okay.
And from here, well, Sir Larry, on one of the most unusual things we've seen, a backfire indeed. We have Pierre on one side and Eric on the other. Eric says, I'll be smart, I'll go down. Bing. But from there, the cover by Tony Garea, the fan sensing victory. And that's exactly what it was. Plus, Lou Albano got his due. Join us next week.